Statue.
Today we will cover last lecture of hemodynamic system, lecture 5, embolism. We will cover definition, description of causes and types of embolism. The learning objective of today's lecture are: students should be able to define embolism, describe causes of embolism, describe different type of embolism. So we will cover all these one by one. What is embolism? It is defined as detached intravascular solid liquid or gaseous mass that is carried by blood to different site from point of origin. After traveling by the blood, the embolus can obstruct a vessel. So जे थ्रोम्बोसिस बनेलू इंट्रावास्क्युलर इफ इट डिटेच फ्रॉम इट्स साइट एंड मूव थ्रू ब्लड टू अदर साइट देन इट इज एम्बोलिज्म और एम्बोलस दिस एम्बोलस कैन और मे लॉज इन पल्मोनरी और सिस्टमिक सर्कुलेशन एंड रिजल्ट इन पार्शियल और कंप्लीट वास्कुलर ऑक्लूजन जे ब्लड वेसल में ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट थाय it may lead to obstruction to blood supply of that particular organ. And that is ischemia. So the affected organ may get infarcted. This figure shows, this is a section of vessel, shows presence of embolus. Type of embolus or emboli. There are different types. Most common is atherosclerotic. Arise from thromboemboli, majority of case, fat embolism, air embolism, amniotic fluid embolism, cellular embolism. It may contain cellular component like neoplastic cell in certain cancer, bacterial colonies in infective lesion or sepsis, or trophoblastic cell, foreign body embolism, or bone marrow embolism. What is the effect of embolus? It may obstruct the blood flow to particular tissue. So the effect depends on the precise site. कई जगह embolus फैलूँ कई वेसल पर. It depends on site, size, at least size से embolus भी. And whether there is alternative blood supply present or not. कोई पर्टिकुलर टिश्यू के ऑर्गन में एक ही सप्लाई हो ब्लड सप्लाई अगर एक वेसल में एम्बोलाई डेवलप था देन इट मे गेट इन्फार्क्टेड बट अल्टरनेटिव ब्लड सप्लाई हो देन क्लिनिकल साइन एंड सिम्टम्स आर साइलेंट और इट मे बी रिवर्सिबल सो द कंसीक्वेंस इंक्लूड इस्केमिक नेक्रोसिस और इन्फेक्शन ऑफ पर्टिकुलर टिश्यू सो डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एम्बोलिज्म दीज आर थ्रोम्बो एम्बोलाई The source of emboli are either deep vein of leg or pelvic vein. It causes pulmonary embolism. Fibrillating atrium, which may lead to systemic embolism. Atherosclerotic plaque debris. It may obstruct the large or medium-sized artery and cause infarction in downstream tissues. Or infective agitation. These are cellular emboli composed of bacteria. If it may set into heart wall, may lead to development of vegetation. If it is on right side, it may lead to clinical signs and symptoms in lungs, and left side heart wall to brain and systemic circulation. Amniotic fluid embolism. It develops in uterus at the time of delivery if there is particular tear in fetal membrane, uterine vein or placenta. Nitrogen embolism. It develops in decompression sickness, particularly seen in diving, scuba diving. You know, if rapid decompression is there, the air accumulates in the vessel and form the embolus composed of nitrogen. It may obstruct and give effect to lung, heart, spinal cord, skeleton, or other vital organs. Air embolism. major surgery kari hoy, it may lead to introduction of air into circulation in great vein of chest. Fat embolism, bony fracture, vehicular accident, long bone of leg fracture kya hota hai? Fat may form embolism in vessels and it may lead to infarction in lung, brain or kidney. So pulmonary thromboembolism is seen in 20-25 per 1 lakh hospitalized patient. It may be fatal if 60% of the circulation is obstructed. This is the cut section of bifurcation of pulmonary artery. This is saddle pulmonary embolism or embolus. It is saddle shape. Obstructed bifurcation of pulmonary artery. It is seen in immobilized patient or long prolonged at rest from hospitalization. Cut section of pulmonary vasculature, you can see the presence of embolus in pulmonary artery. Pulmonary arterial embolism is potentially fatal. They are reported in more than half of the all autopsy. The complication occurring 1-2% of post-operative patient in patient above 40 years. The risk of development of pulmonary arterial embolism is more if patient has advancing age like elderly patient, obese patient, prolonged operative procedure, if patient has post-operative sepsis, presence of other comorbid condition like cancer or pre-existing venous disease. In this condition or in this situation, the chances of development of pulmonary arterial embolism is more. Clinical manifestation depend on the size of the emboli and the place at which it lodges. If it is large, it may completely block the artery and obstruct the blood flow to lungs. Lungs are generally safer from infarction because lung has got dual blood supply. So if emboli develop in one of the vessels, then collateral blood flow from bronchial artery supply the lungs through collaterals. Clinical manifestation, cyanosis and shortness of breath due to inadequate oxygenation of blood. If the emboli is large, then the right side of the heart becomes distended, pulmonary artery become over distended with blood, and so ultimately there is increased pulmonary pressure. Left ventricle so unable to pump adequate amount of blood to systemic organ, brain and other vital organs, and so there is decrease or fall in the systemic blood pressure and patient may go into the shock. If emboli size is small, then it may pass through the pulmonary arteries and impact it in peripheral arteries. So it affects the lower lobe of the lung. Here also pulmonary pressure is raised and inadequate collateral circulation. Affected lung segment may get necrosis. So there is development of wedge-shaped pulmonary infarct. Clinical signs and symptoms are dyspnea, pleuritic chest pain, cough, expectoration of bloody sputum due to leakage of blood from infarcted lung tissue and bronchi. Diagnosis of pulmonary embolism, chest x-ray, we cannot detect the embolism or embolus by chest x-ray. Chest x-ray just detect the infarct or ischemic portion. Lungs can detect abnormal pulmonary blood flow. If there is emboli which obstruct the pulmonary blood flow, then lungs can give the clue that this particular vessel there is decreased blood supply. So chances of emboli are there. Pulmonary angiography, it can detect the blockage of pulmonary artery. CT scan, it is non-invasive procedure, so it is better than angiography. can detect or diagnose the obstructed flow of contrast media. So acute pulmonary embolism is divided into Follen syndrome. It may, if the size of emboli is small, then asymptomatic, or it may lead to transient dyspnea and tachypnea without other symptoms. If it is large enough, then it may lead to pulmonary infarction with development of pleuritic chest pain, hemoptysis and pleural effusion, cardiovascular collapse with sudden death if it is large enough. So pulmonary embolism that occurs chronically with numerous or multiple emboli lodged in the small artery of lung can lead to development of pulmonary hypertension and right-sided heart failure. Fit. Once emboli develop, it may dissolve, but which are the criteria? It depends on the embolic load, adequacy of the pulmonary vascular reserve, state of the bronchial collateral circulation, and activity of thrombolytic process. In last lecture, we have covered that thrombolytic activity in physiological condition. After it bursts over, the thrombi get resolved. Similarly, emboli, depending on the activity of thrombolytic system or fibrinolytic system, emboli may also resolve or it may organize. The sequelae of pulmonary thromboembolism is it may lead to sudden death if obstruct the large vessels or give ischemia to vital organs, or in case of smaller size, it remains silent, there is resolution and organization, or lead to development of dyspnea or pulmonary infarction. In addition to this pulmonary arterial emboli, certain other miscellaneous conditions in which emboli develop, for example, in intravenous drug abuser. Drug abuser use talcum powder as a carrier. Powder on the injector, along with drug, certain amount of talcum powder may introduce into the lung. So the emboli composed of this powder here, it produces granulomatous response in the lung. Cotton emboli, while we are doing venipuncture for collection of blood, we clean the spirit, betadine spirit. Okay, after clean kariye, then cotton di kariye. If that cotton portion may inserted into the vessel, then it may lead to development of emboli composed of cotton. Schistosomiasis, it may be associated with embolization of ova. So this schistosomia, egg or ova, may go to the lung from bladder or GIT and lead to granulomatous giant cell reaction or foreign body reaction. In certain type of disseminated cancer, this cancerous cell form tumor emboli which go to the lung and cause infarction. Paradoxical emboli, it refers to emboli that arise in venous circulation. Venous mein develop thai, but systemic artery mein jaye, it bypass the lung. So it is called as paradoxical. Generally, vein mein jaye, artery mein jaye, pehle lung aaye. But here, it bypass the lung, it may seen in incompletely closed foramen oval. So it enters the left side of the heart and block the flow of blood to systemic arteries. Since the pressure in left atrium usually exceeds that in the right, it is seen in right to left shunt. Hardly almost shunt have a congenital heart disease. So it is seen in this right to left shunt. Incompletely closed foramen oval. Systemic arterial embolism often causes infarct. Heart is the most common source of arterial thromboemboli. It arises from mural thrombi. These emboli tend to lodge at points where the vessel lumen narrows abruptly. So the side is sudden narrowing of the lumen, J side, where it can lodge there. For example, we have seen in bifurcation of pulmonary artery. Then bifurcation of the single artery, then lost it. Okay. So viability of the tissue supply by vessel depend on the availability of the collateral circulation and fate or degradation of the embolism. So if organ has got dual blood supply, the clinical signs and symptoms or clinical sequelae will be silent or less if there is collateral circulation. Or this thromboembolism may propagate locally and lead to more severe obstruction. This arterial thromboembolism, depending on the organ affected, it may lead to following changes. For example, if emboli are developed in the vessels supplying the heart, there is ischemic necrosis of brain tissue. Similarly, if emboli develop in mesenteric circulation, this emboli cause infarction of the GI system or bowel. So patient present with acute abdomen and it requires immediate laparotomy. If emboli develop in large vein or large arteries of the leg, so there is sudden acute onset of pain, absence of pulse and cold limb on palpation. So this is also a surgical emergency. Limb must be amputated as early as possible. In kidney, renal artery embolism may infarct the entire kidney or may form small infarct. Similarly, heart coronary artery or emboli develop thigh, it may lead to acute myocardial infarction. So immediate thrombolytic process start required and immediate surgical intervention is required if these vital organs are affected. Air embolism, name itself suggests emboli is composed of air. Air abhi kya thi? Vessel mein air kya thi abhi? Andar to hai nahi. It may inserted from outside. Kevi te insert hai? कोई मेजर सर्जरी करी हुई और ड्यूरिंग पाइप आईवी लाइन चढ़ा हुई है बॉटल में जी एयर आपने जो काढ़ी रखा हुई है ना तो लाइन जो रही गई देन एयर में गेट एंटर्ड इनटू द सर्कुलेशन इफ इट इज स्मॉलर इन क्वांटिटी देन इट गेट डिसॉल्व बट लार्ज हो जाए इट में कॉज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्बोलाई एंड अदर इंपॉर्टेंट वेहिकुलर एक्सीडेंट नेक वुंड हो थोरेकोसेंटेसिस large surgical procedure, puncture of great vein during invasive procedure or hemodialysis, obstetric gynae or other laparoscopic procedure, small amount of circulating air in the form of bubble are of critical consequence, it gets dissolved. But if it is in large quantity, more than 100 ml, then it may lead to obstruction or ischemic infarction in vital organs and may lead to death. Air bubble tend to coalesce and physically obstruct the flow to blood in right side of the heart, pulmonary circulation and brain, while air carried into the right chamber and prevent filling of heart by returning venous blood. So ultimately heart is unable to pump blood and person dies rapidly because of the circulatory failure. This bubble of air appeared as empty spaces. Microscopically air through it, then it is not visible, air dekha hi nahi, naked eye par nahi dekha hai, microscopically par nahi dekha, so it appears as empty spaces. You can see it in cut section of capillaries and small vessels of the lung. Person exposed to increased atmospheric pressure like a scuba diver and worker in underwater occupation, exposed to this condition known as decompression sickness. एकदम फॉर्मेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन विच इज इनसॉल्युबल इन ब्लड दिस नाइट्रोजन फॉर्म एम्बोलाई दिस इज गैस एम्बोलाई इट इज एम्बोलिज्म इट इज सेकंड मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ डेथ इन स्पॉट डाइविंग डाइवर जो है ना सी मार में डाइव करता है ये माय इट इज अ कॉमन कॉज आपने नहीं चाहिए. Acute decompression sickness, commonly known as the bend, is characterized by temporary muscular and joint pain, severe joint pain type, because of the obstruction. If it obstructs or involves the cerebral blood vessel, then it may lead to coma or even sudden death. Cason disease is a type of decompression sickness in which vascular assortments from the bio. Our थोड़ा ट्रिकी नाम है जैसे एग्जामिनर ने तो इट इज अ कंडीशन और टाइप ऑफ डिकम्प्रेस सिकनेस इन व्हिच वास्कुलर ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन कॉजेस मल्टीपल फोकाई ऑफ इश्चेमिक नेक्रोसिस ऑफ बोन पर्टिकुलरली अफेक्ट द हेड ऑफ फीमर ह्यूमरस एंड टीबिया. एमनियोटिक फ्लूइड एम्बोलिज्म क्या है? एमनियोटिक फ्लूइड सेवा
hematopoietic cell
bone marrow embolism, cut section of pulmonary artery. Septic embolism. Sepsis means systemic infection. Septicemia. It contains presence of proliferating bacteria. Actively proliferating bacteria lead to sepsis. So this septic embolism composed of bacterial colonies. The more bacteria are growing, they invade the thrombi, dislodge from the site of origin and transport through the blood. So thrombi forming pelvic vein following uterine infection or infected thrombus travel to lung and cause pulmonary infarct. Bacteria in blood invade the pulmonary infarct causing lung abscess. Septicemia. So next, Monday 4 to 5. Come with full preparation. 5 topics. First, edema. Second, hyperemia, congestion and hemorrhage. Third topic, shock. Fourth, hemostasis and thrombosis. And fifth, embolism. So self-directed learning is there. Next week, Monday. Thank you.